Hello children, see we have started with the honeycomb all lessons. Now there will be another lesson, that is a bicycle in good repair. Open a page number, honeycomb page number 126, ninth lesson. You can see here on the screen, a bicycle in good repair. Now you know children, you like to ride a bicycle. If you see here, they have asked some question. If you wish to go on a long bicycle ride, the bicycle should be in good condition. You know children, if you want to go on a long drive, you need a vehicle to be in good condition. And if you wish to go on a long drive on bicycle, you need the bicycle in good condition. If possible, an expert mechanic should overhaul it. And if it is not in a good condition and you have to go to an expert mechanic and you have to make it in a good condition, that bicycle, so that you can ride on that. Then, but what happens if the machine has a will of its own and the mechanic knows next to nothing? Suppose if the machine is in any other condition and if the mechanic doesn't know anything about it, what will happen? Yes children, because if it is not in a good condition and even if the mechanic is not knowing anything about the machine, then there will be something may happen. Okay, serious thing may happen and you won't be able to ride a bicycle. So here if you see a lesson, a bicycle in good repair, we are going to see this lesson now. And it is a really one story, and this story is written by Jerome K. Jerome. This is a story written by Jerome K. Jerome. So we start with a new lesson, that is a bicycle in good repair. A man I knew proposed one evening, we should go for a long bicycle ride together on the following day, and I agreed. So one man, he told that other man that today we are going to go on a long bicycle ride next day, and this boy, he agreed with that. I got up early for me, I made an effort and was pleased with myself, and this boy, he was really very happy to go on a long drive on the bicycle, and he got up early and he made up his all the things, and then he was very happy to go. He came half an hour late, but that man, he came half an hour late. I was waiting for him in the garden, and this boy, he was waiting in the garden for that man. It was a lovely day. He said, "That's good looking machine of yours, how does it run?" When that man came, he looked at the bicycle and he said, your bicycle is really in good condition, and that machine is also good," he is saying. "And how does it run?" Now he is asking. "Oh, like most of them," this boy is telling, "like other bicycles only it runs, means it is in good condition," I answered. "Easily enough in the morning, goes a little stiffly after lunch." Then after, they decided that after lunch we'll go on a ride. He caught hold of it by the front wheel and the fork and shook it violently. This man, what he did, you know, he took that bicycle and he caught that front wheel and the fork and shook it violently, and he started shaking that wheel. I said, "Don't do that, you will hurt it." This boy is telling that man that don't shake that wheel, otherwise you will get hurt out of it. I did not see why he should shake it, and he was not knowing why he is shaking that wheel. It had not done anything to him, and he was not understanding that as my bicycle is in good condition, but why this man is he's shaking the front wheel. Besides, if it wanted shaking, I was the proper person to shake it. And he said, why he want to do that thing? I am there to shake that front wheel, but why he is doing that? I felt much as I should had he started whacking my dog. Then started beating my dog. Whacking my dog means beating or sticking my dog, he is saying. He said, "This front wheel wobbles." He is saying, that man is telling that, "See, your front wheel is there, the bicycle's front wheel is wobbling, means it is shaking, and it is not steady, means it is shaking from side to side." I said, "It doesn't if you don't wobble it." It didn't wobble. As a matter of fact, nothing worth calling a wobble. He said, "No, but you, until and unless you wobble the wheel, it is not going to shake. you are doing this, you are doing such thing, because whenever I use my bicycle, I don't need to, means there is nothing any serious about my bicycle, it is in good condition. You are wobbling it, that's why the front wheel is wobbling. He said, this is dangerous. That man is saying, no, no, this is very dangerous. Have you got a hammer? Now he is asking for the hammer. I ought to have been firm, but I thought that perhaps he really did know something about the business. Now what he thought, maybe he might be knowing something about that bicycle, that's why he's asking. And this boy did not want to give that hammer and everything because his cycle was in good condition. But then too, what he thought, he might be knowing something else. So he gave the things to check out the bicycle. Then this boy, what he did, I went to the tool shed to see what I could find. He went to the tool shed and he started finding out the hammer and everything. When I came back, he was sitting on the ground with the front wheel between his legs. When he came out of the shed, he saw that man, he is sitting on the ground with the front wheel, between his legs. You can see in the picture there. He was playing with it. He was playing with that front wheel, twiddling it round between his fingers. He was twiddling with the fingers. Okay. The remnant of the machine was lying on the gravel path beside him. What had happened? The remnant path, remnant means remaining part, what was happening? Remaining part of the machine was lying on the gravel path beside him. And the remaining part was on the ground, and that front wheel was in that man's hand, and he was shaking, was playing with that front wheel. Then he said, it looks to me as if the bearings were all wrong. Now he is saying, see, whatever bearings are there in the wheel, those all are wrong. I said, don't you trouble about it anymore. You will make yourself tired. Let us put it back and get off. He is saying, you are troubling yourself. It's not the thing that my cycle is not in a good condition. You are troubling yourself. So keep the things as it is, and now we will move off to the ride. But this man, what he said, you see now. He said, we may as well see what is the matter with it. Now it is out. He talked as though it had dropped out by accident. He is telling something might have happened because of accident, and we will check it, and then only we will move out to the ride. This man is not at all listening. Before I could stop, he had unscrewed something somewhere and out rolled all over the path some dozen or so little balls. But this man, as this boy was talking with that man, here that man, he was doing his own business. He removed all the screws, and the front wheel was now loosened, and all the balls, all the bearings, they came out of that wheel, and they were all on the ground now. Catch them, he shouted. Catch them. We mustn't lose any of them. He was quite excited about them. Now this man, he's, because those balls were there and they were rolling on the ground. So this man, what he said, come on, you go and catch the bearings, because we need them. If we lose one bearing also, it will be difficult for us to put it again. And he was very, very excited about that. We groveled round for grovel means we crawled. We groveled round for half an hour and found 16. So he many, I think some bearings he has lost also, and he was just crawling on the ground. That boy was crawling on the ground, and he found out 16, that those balls. He said, he hoped we had got them all. That man is telling, I hope we had got all the balls back, because if not, it would make a serious difference to the machine. And if you don't get the balls, it would make a serious difference to the machine. I put them for safety in my hat. What this man he did, he took all the bearings and he put that bearings in the hat. It was not a sensible thing to do, I admit. He said it was really no use. It was really there was no reason only to remove that front wheel. Everything was okay, and then too you have done this thing. Then see here, next he then said that while he was about it, he would see into the chain for me. Now he turned to the chain. What he did, that man, he left the front wheel and he started looking at the chain and at once began taking off the gear case. He removed that gear case also from the bicycle. I did try to dissuade him from that and I was trying to avoid the thing from doing, but this man was not at all listening to that boy. I told him what an experienced friend of mine once said to me solemnly, if anything goes wrong with your gear case, sell the machine and buy a new one. It comes cheaper. See, I did try to dissuade him from that. And this boy, he was trying to avoid that man from doing that those things by removing all the machines and everything. Because the cycle was in good condition, but this man, he is doing some other business. And what he told, I have an experienced friend, this boy, he told that man that I have an experienced friend and he told me that if something is wrong in the gear case, you sell the machine and I will give you a new one that is cheaper. He said people like talk like that who understand nothing about machines. This man, what he is commenting, you know, see children, he is saying, array, your friend is, he is not, he might be not having any experience about the machines. So he is telling like that, and the people just they tell these things because they won't be knowing about anything about their machines. Nothing is easier than taking off a gear case. What is saying? Nothing is easier than taking off a gear case. He said, it is very easy to take off the gear case. I had to confess he was right. And at last, this boy, he said, after so many arguments or after, he was really not excited. He was really very unhappy because this man, he was doing something else only. And he said, at last, I have to confess that he is only right person. Because he was saying, my friend is not experienced. He might be not knowing anything about the machines. And even I am not knowing anything about the machine. My cycle is not in good condition. And lastly, he has to confess that whatever he is saying, that is right. In less than 5 minutes, he had the gear case in 2 pieces. What this man did? Really, he removed the gear case and he broke it into 2 pieces. Lying on the path and was groveling for screws. And again, he started searching the screws and he was crawling on the ground and he was searching for the screws. He said it was always a mystery to him the way screws disappeared. He said, what this man says, screws, they all are very, very small. And we could not find it very easily. This man is saying that, it is really one mystery only for me because whenever I lose the screws, I never get it. And it's the fact, children, many times we don't get all the screws. Then to this boy, he's crawling and he's trying to find out the screws. Common sense continued to whisper to me, stop him before he does any more mischief. Now this boy is really very tensed and he is saying, his mind is saying to him that you stop this man, otherwise he will do some other mischief only and he will spoil, he will damage the bicycle. So he is now, that thing is coming in his mind. You have a right to protect your own property from the ravages of a lunatic. He is saying, see, every person has a right to to keep their property or to look after their property. Why is this man simply doing all these things? Because the property belongs to that man, boy. And why this person is simply involving, doing such things? Because that bicycle belongs to that boy. Now, see, every person has the right to protect their own property from the other people. Ravages means damaging it. It is our right. And lunatic means mad person. This mad person was really like a mad only, we can say. Because the cycle is in good condition and simply he is removing all the parts of the bicycle. This thing can only a mad people can do. So this means something is coming in his mind that the property is mine and I have to look after my property. Then see what happened. Take him by the scruff of the neck and kick him out of the gate. He was really now very angry. He thought I should hold him and throw out of the gate. He was feeling like that and these things came in his mind. And now what that boy did, we'll see. But I'm weak when it comes to hurting other people's feelings and I let him meddle on. This boy, he was not that much bold. He felt that he was very weak in these things. He did not like to hurt any other people's feelings. So what he did? He started mixing up all the things again, and I let him muddle on. He told that let him do whatever he want to do now. He gave up looking for the rest of the Scrooge. Now he waited there only, that boy. Let him do whatever he wanted to do, and he waited. He was just watching at that man. He said Scrooge had a knack of turning up when he least expected them, and that now he would see to the chain. He left that his damage, that front wheel also, that gear case also. Now he turned up to the chain. He tightened it till it would not move. Next he loosened it, and until it was twice as loose as it before. He first loosened the chain. Then again he tightened the chain, and again it loosened the chain. He loosened the chain as it was before. Now it was very, very loose. And children, you know, if the chain is loose, you are not able to ride a bicycle. Then he said, we had better think about getting the front wheel back into its place again. Now he is saying that what we'll do, we will place the front wheel again back on its place. I held the fork open and he worried with the wheel. At the end of 10 minutes, I suggested he should hold the fork and that I should handle the wheel, and we changed places. So now they change the places, and now they are again, they want to place that front wheel again on the same place. See how they are doing. If you see on the page 130, you can see there. Then at the end of 10 minutes, I suggested I should hold the fork and that I should handle the wheel and we change places. Now this boy, he is trying to put that wheel again back to its place. At length we did get the thing into position, and within few minutes he placed that wheel again on the same place. And the moment it was in position, he burst out laughing. And when he placed that placed that wheel on the first on the previous place, this man, he started laughing. He burst out into laughing. I said, what's the joke? He said, well, I am an ass. He said, see, this boy is asking, why are you laughing? Simply, did I crack any joke? Why are you laughing? This boy is asking to that man. What this man said? He said, well, I am an ass. He is saying, I am stupid. Really, I am stupid. It was the first thing he had said that made me respect him. This boy, what is saying? Now I am feeling like respecting him, because now he only accepted that he was really a mad person, and that was the first thing that I felt really like respecting him. I asked him what had led him to the discovery. I asked him why you did all such things. He said, we have forgotten the balls. I looked for my hat. It was lying topsy-turvy in the middle of the path. He was of a cheerful disposition. He said, well, we must put back all we can find and trust to Providence. This man, what he's saying? It was the first thing that I asked him what had led him to the discovery. This man, he said, why you discovered all these things? What he said? See, he said, we have forgotten the balls. I looked for my hat. Now this man is searching for the balls, and the balls were in the hat. It was lying topsy-turvy. It was upside down. That hat was upside down and the balls was inside the hat, means below that hat. And he was searching all the balls everywhere. He was of a cheerful disposition. He said, well, we must put back all we can find. He said, now we will put everything back to the bicycle and trust to Providence. See now, after that he found 11. We found 11. We fixed 6 on one side and 5 on the other side. Very good. What he did? He found only 11 balls, and what he did? He fixed 6 on one side and the 5 on the other side. And half an hour later, the wheel was in its place again. So after half an hour, the wheel was on its place again. It need hardly be added that it really did wobble now. now he is finding that really that my bicycle, the wheel is wobbling or what. A child might have noticed it, he said, it would do for the present. Then that boy, what he said, it's okay now and everything is okay, so let's move for the ride. I said, watching you do this is of really use to me. Real use to me. He is saying, whatever things you have done, really it is useful for me or what? It is not only your skill that fascinates me, it is your cheery confidence in yourself, your inexplicable hopefulness that does me good. He said that, really this is one mystery only for me, why you have done such all things, because everything was in good condition, and why you have done such all things, and very happily you have done all these things. Thus encouraged, he set to work to refix the gear case. Now, after placing the wheel, he started fixing the gear case. He stood the bicycle against the house and worked from the offside. And what he did? He hold the bicycle in front of the house, against the house, and then he started his work by fixing the gear case. Then he stood it against tree. And then he went and stood against the tree and worked from the onside. Then I held it for him while he lay on the ground with his head between the wheels. He put his head on the ground and he started fixing the gear to the bicycle and worked at it from below and dropped oil upon himself. See, we have to put oil also for that. And when he was putting the oil in the gear case, all the oil was on his body, that man's body dropped on his body. Then he took it away from me and doubled himself across it till he lost his balance and slid over onto his head. This man, he was lying on the ground and he was fixing the gear case. As he was fixing the gear case, he was dropping the oil in the gear case. And when he was doing that thing, all the oil was dropped on his body. And this man, when he wanted to, he lost his balance and he slid on his head. Then he lost his temper. Now this man, he got very angry because he slid and tried bullying the thing. The bicycle, I was glad to see, showed spirit, and the subsequent proceedings degenerated into little else than a rough and tumble fight between him and the machine. This man, he was really, really very angry on, because he was able to remove everything, but it was difficult for him to place it again on the place, on the same place. And something or the other is happening. He got injured because of that. He fell down and he was really angry on, he lost his temper and he was angry on his own, because he was really fighting with the machine like to place them in the proper order. One moment the bicycle would be on the gravel path and he on top of it. What was happening? Once the bicycle was on him, and the other time the bicycle, he was under the bicycle. The next, the position would be reversed. He on the gravel path, the bicycle on him. Now he would be standing flushed with victory, the bicycle firmly fixed between his legs. At last, something or the other else, he fixed all the things on the same place. And he means as if he has done some great thing, as if he got the victory by placing all the machines on its own place. And he was behaving. But his triumph would be short-lived. By a sudden quick movement, it would free itself and turning up upon him, hit him sharply over the head with one of its handle. And when he was getting up, after doing all the things, when he was getting up, what happened, you know, children? He got struck because of the handle. He got hurt to his head. At a quarter to one, dirty and disheveled, cut and bleeding, he said, I think that will do, and rose and wiped his brow. And when he got up, now he was ready. That bicycle was on, means in a good condition now. Actually, it was in good condition only, but this man don't know why he has done all these things. And then he got up and he saw that his clothes were all dirty and disheveled, and he was bleeding also. He stood up and he said, now everything is okay. The bicycle looked as if it also had enough of it. Bicycle, after looking to the bicycle also might be thinking, now enough how much you are troubling for me, as if the bicycle was looking at that man. Which had received most punishment, it would have been difficult to say. Poor that bicycle, simply the bicycle was looking as if I have received lot of punishment because of you. I took him into the back kitchen where, so far as was possible, he cleaned himself, then I sent him home. So this, after what he did, after that boy, he took him to the kitchen, he cleaned that man, and then later on he sent that man back to the home. So whatever they have decided to go on a long drive on the bicycle was in vain. Okay, in vain it was. Then they did not go on a long drive. Vice versa, this man, what he did, he as if he troubled that boy also, and for that bicycle also, because simply he did not want to, actually he did not, I think he did not want to go on a ride, and simply he removed all this machine and tried to set all the machine back to the place, and in that also he also got hurt. Okay, that man also, he got hurt. And then this boy, what he did, he took him back to the kitchen, he cleaned that man, and then that boy, what he did, he sent that man back to his house. Because see, one thing what it is told here, that even the bicycle was also feeling that this man, simply he is troubling me, he is giving me a punishment, because actually the bicycle was in a good condition only. So I hope children, you might have liked this story. See how it is, a bicycle in good repair. The name, if you see, a bicycle in good repair means what? Actually the bicycle was in good condition, and again repairing it was no need for repairing also, but the name what is given, a bicycle in good repair. So this man was thinking that this bicycle is not in good condition, and before going, you check the vehicle. So he thought, before going on a long drive, we'll check the vehicle, and actually it was in good condition. Then to this man, he wanted to repair the bicycle as if he wanted to show that he is very expert in repairing. I hope children, you might have liked this story. And the other thing is what, you have to read the whole story, and whatever meanings are there, you have to write it, plus whatever hard words are given here, you have to write those hard words given here. And then some question answers are also given at the back exercise. You will be getting the questions answers for that, and later on I will be sending you the answers for that. So please go through this lesson, read it once again, and try to understand the story. I hope children have liked this story. And just one thing I want to tell you, see here, if you see on the next page here, one poem is there, Garden Snake. I want to tell you, just go through this Garden Snake poem. See what it is. Have you ever seen a snake fighting with a mongoose, or getting into a hole, or swimming in the river? Almost everyone we have seen. Believe that snakes, they are dangerous. We know that. Some are most and some are not. So read this poem on a harmless garden snake. So read this poem. I saw a snake and ran away. Some snakes are dangerous, they say, but mother says that kind is good and eats up insects for his food. So when he wiggles in the grass, I will stand aside and watch him pass, and tell myself there's no mistake, it's just a harmless garden snake. This poem is written by Mural L. Sony. And mother, she wants to tell that, see, all the snakes are not dangerous. Some snakes are dangerous, and mother, she is saying it is kind because they eat the insects. And when you see the snake is wiggling in the grass, you just stand aside and let the snake pass away from there, and tell yourself that there is no mistake, it's just a harmless garden snake. It is really a garden snake. This poem also, you are going to write it in your notebook whenever I will tell you. I hope children, you have understood this poem also. It's really very short, and we can take this poem for the reading section. So I hope that you have understood the lesson also, and regarding this garden snake. Thank you.